Bruins just got blasted.
Matt Cook, the hit just as that shot was released. And they're going at Cook right now. And one of the Bruins on his backside.
Marc Savard was an extremely talented winger for the Oshawa Generals, who took the OHL by storm, setting a league high in points and dominating the competition. In only his second season in Oshawa, he'd post 139 total points, destroying the OHL and truly making a name for himself. To make things even better, he'd go on to produce another 130 point season a year later. And at this point, Savard looked like a lock for the NHL. And when the New York Rangers saw that he was still available on the draft board, they selected him 91st overall. Savard would head back to the OHL for a few more seasons, where his dominance would continue, helping the Generals into the playoffs and guiding them to a Ross Robinson Cup and an appearance in the 1997 Memorial Cup. Savard would be a huge factor as he'd post 24 points in 15 playoff games, enough to help Savard land a roster spot in Hartford, the Rangers affiliate team, where he'd produce 74 points. Savard's unique playmaking abilities helped him get into the big leagues as the following season he'd get called up to the Rangers to play a big role. He'd go on to play 70 games while racking up 40 points, but Savard wouldn't be in New York for much longer, as in 1999, they'd trade him to the Calgary Flames for a first and third round pick. Savard would continue to excel in Calgary, even finishing second in team scoring in the 2000-2001 season with 65 points. Savard was establishing himself as a legit NHL forward, but one trade in 2002 would help Savard become a household name. November 15th, 2002. The Flames would ship Savard off to the Atlanta Thrashers in exchange for Ruslan Zenonulin. This trade would change Savard's entire career. Now, playing with superstar wingers Danny Heatley and Ilya Kovalchuk, Savard would become a point per game player, recording 52 points in 45 games during an injury-shortened season. Savard would return the following season to put on a show, emerging as a top talent in the league with a career-high 97 points. This performance was good enough for 9th overall in the entire league. Atlanta's Big 3 was poised to take the league by storm. Their only problem, Savard was set to become a free agent and he wanted a hefty contract. Savard would head to free agency looking for a big deal, eventually signing a 4-year, $5 million contract with the Boston Bruins. Savard was now hoping to continue where he left off, and sure enough.
Chena had it stolen by San Luis. Errant pass in the slot, access and picks it off for Murray. Left side, Savard score! Pass looking for Savard in on the near wing. Throws it at the net, and it's in! P.J. Axelson, I believe, will get the goal. Savard threw it at the net. It rattled in off somebody. Bruins with it. Mara, cross ice. Score! Glenn Murray!
Savard's first season in Boston, he put up 96 points, proving to be an elite playmaker, as his whopping 74 assists were good enough for third best in the league. Savard's efforts would eventually land him a spot in the All-Star game in 2008, replacing Danny Heatley, who ironically was a former teammate of his. Savard's point total dropped to 78 due to an injury, but he was able to take part in the playoffs against Montreal that season, and even though the Bruins wouldn't win the series, Savard still proved to be a key contributor for the team. All was looking up for him, but his career would soon take a turn in the wrong direction, eventually leading to heartbreak. 7 games into the 09-10 season, Savard sustained a broken foot while blocking a shot. He'd be placed on the long-term injury list, eventually coming back to play. Savard would later receive a 7-year contract extension with the Bruins worth $4.2 million a year. Little did anyone know, however, was that Savard's new contract was about to cover up a chain of terrible injuries that would take place, and eventually end Savard's career.
Playing Penguin hockey to try to vanquish the Boston Bruins here today, but here's Lucic into the zone, drops it off, and a high shot sails over the shoulder. One of the Bruins just got blasted.
Matt Cook, the hit just as that shot was released, and they're going at Cook right now. And one of the Bruins on his backside.
That's
March 7th, 2010, Savard suffered a grade 2 concussion in the third period of a Bruins-Penguins game after getting a shoulder to the head from Matt Cook. The officials did not penalize Cook for the hit, and 3 days after the incident, it was announced that the NHL would not suspend or fine Cook for the hit. The hit and the aftermath were part of key evidence that caused the NHL to institute a new rule that more heavily penalized blindside hits. Savard wasn't taken to the hospital following the hit, and actually suited up for the playoffs to face off against the Flyers. This would be one of the last good things we'd see that come out of Savard's career. Savard was diagnosed with post-concussion syndrome during the offseason, missing the first 23 games of the 2010-11 season. Despite eventually returning, Savard's performance wasn't nearly to par as it once was. On January 23, 2011, Savard suffered a second concussion on a hit by former Bruin player Matt Hunway. The Bruins opted to shut down Savard for the season after he received his second concussion in 10 months. The Bruins would go on to win the Stanley Cup, defeating the Vancouver Canucks in 7 games, and due to reoccurring symptoms of post-concussion syndrome, Savard was not able to take part on the on-ice victory celebration with his teammates, but he was still able to join the parade. However, controversy erupted, as despite Savard not playing the required number of games for his name to be on the Stanley Cup, the Bruins petitioned the league to include Savard's name in the engravement. Bruins general manager Peter Chiarelli announced that the organization would shut Savard down for the upcoming season. Unfortunately, this would be the last time we'd see Savard in an NHL sweater. Savard's contract would later be traded not once but twice to both the Devils and the Panthers. Savard would officially announce his retirement on January 28, 2018, once his contract was officially up. Even though his injury prevented him from suiting up, it still to this day hasn't prevented Savard from expressing the love for the game. If you want to hear about Savard and what he's currently up to, you can find him on his own YouTube channel. Savard's videos focus on taping twigs based off past and current NHL players' sticks. He even showcased how he used to tape his own stick as well. Savard's legacy will always be overshadowed due to his concussion faced in 2010. But no one will ever forget the impact he had on his team and the impact he had on the game.